The 110-story World Trade Center towers were designed to withstand the impact of a commercial jetliner. Yet within 2 hours of the attacks, both collapse. So why did the Twin Towers fail so disastrously and so quickly? Under public pressure, the U.S. government commissions a $16 million investigation from the National Institute of Standards and Technology in an attempt to explain the structural failures of the towers. They examine the debris from the disaster, run hundreds of computer simulations, and conduct extensive lab tests. The official government report into the Twin Towers tragedy only tackled events on the initial impact floors, not the physics behind the subsequent collapse. It left the field wide open for conspiracy theorists who point to the unexpectedly rapid collapse amid reports of explosions. Nuclear chemist Dr. Frank Greening was also surprised that the towers collapsed so quickly.
I watched this whole thing unfold like everybody did. And then, of course, the South Tower collapses. The top section just crushes the lower section. A little later, the North Tower does the same thing, and I'm just shocked, horrified, and I say to myself, how could this happen?
Greening felt that until the mechanics of the collapse were properly understood, the fanatical rumors would simply not go away. He decided to calculate whether the towers would collapse under their own weight, without the need for explosives.
The first thing I felt needed to be cleared up was, could the building collapse the way we saw it, or did it actually need help from explosives, as some people were suggesting? I really threw myself into 9/11 research, and I decided I wanted to apply science, physics to studying this problem. I set up a computer program based on momentum transfer to look at each impact of each floor.
Greening's momentum transfer program calculated the weight of the buildings above the impact floors. He discovered that if one floor failed, the weight of the higher floors would cause each floor below to give way exactly as seen. As the impacts were on different floors, the simulation would need to account for the differing mass above each. There were 15 floors above the impact point in the North Tower and 22 floors above the South Tower. Frank's calculations would also need to prove that the floors below each impact point would disintegrate in a manner that looks similar to a controlled demolition.
I ran the program, and it showed that the buildings would indeed come down. Even more interesting was the computer program predicted the collapse times.
The North Tower falls in 13 seconds, but with a greater number of floors above the impact site of the South Tower, it takes only 11 seconds.
Once the building started to collapse, there was no stopping it. It was a juggernaut. The mass of the upper block in the North Tower is equivalent to the mass of the Titanic. It's about 38,000 tons.